In this session, I'll be going to explain rules to have a plotting of root locus. So let us begin this session with first rule. So first rule, explains root locus is always symmetric with respect to real axis. So root locus plotting is always with symmetric with respect to real axis. The root locus is always symmetric with respect to real axis. So when we plot root locus, plotting of that will always be symmetric with respect to real axis. Second rule, that is to identify number of loci. So second rule that explains total loci, and that is maximum of poles and zeros which is there in transfer function. So if I say I have a system which is having transfer function and that is having p number of poles and z number of zeros, then total loci which is there in root locus plot, that will be maximum of poles or zero. Third rule, that is to have a calculation of number of asymptotes. So this third rule that explains total number of asymptotes. So for a calculation of total number of asymptotes, we need to subtract total number of poles minus total number of zeros. For example, if I say in my transfer function, total number of poles are 3 and total number of zeros are 1, then total number of asymptotes in that given transfer function, that will be 3 minus 1, it will be 2. Fourth rule, that is to find angle of asymptotes. So if I say I have two asymptotes in my system, then in fourth rule, I'll be calculating what is the angle of asymptote. So fourth rule explains angle of asymptotes. If I say that is theta, then that will be 2x plus 1 divided by poles minus 0 into 180 degree, where x is equals to 0, 1, 2. So ultimately, these numbers based on number of asymptotes. So here, in my case, if I say there are two asymptotes, so value of x that we need to substitute 0 once and 1 once in this, and there will be two different angles for that angles of asymptotes. Fifth rule, that is based on calculation of centroid of asymptote. So next rule, that is to have a calculation of centroid of asymptotes. So for a calculation of centroid of asymptotes, we need to have summation of real part of pole minus summation of real part of zeros divided by total number of poles minus total number of zeros. So we need to see how many poles are there, how many zeros are there, and out of those poles, what is the algebraic sum of real parts of poles and what is the algebraic sum of real part of zeros, and subtract that, divide by total number of poles minus total number of zero, that will result into centroid of asymptotes. Now, next rule, that is to have a calculation of breakaway point. So, next rule, rule number 6, that is to have a calculation of breakaway point. So, here when we plot root locus, sixth rule is to identify breakaway point. Now, to identify breakaway point, there are small few steps which is what we need to take to have a calculation of breakaway point. First is to identify characteristic equation, and that we can have it based on 1 plus GS HS is equals to 0. Second step, to have a compute K is equals to polynomial, and third step, that is to have a calculation of dk by ds is equals to 0, and in that case we will be having s is equals to break away point. So breakaway point, that has been bisected in three steps. First is characteristic equation. Second is after characteristic equation compute K, and then after compute dk by ds is equals to 0, and that will result into s is equals to breakaway point. Next rule, that is rule number 7. And this rule is to identify angle of departure. So, angle of departure explains when line is emerging from poles, at what angle that should move further in which direction. So, angle of departure explains at what angle line will get emerged from poles. So, this is what we will be computing it in 7th step, which is angle of departure. And in last step, we are dealing with to calculate intersection to imaginary axis. So, to have a calculation of intersection to imaginary axis, again, I'll be bisecting this in few steps. First step, to have a calculation of characteristic equation, and that we will be calculating as we have calculated earlier, 1 plus GS HS is equals to 0. In this, second step is to construct Routh array. So, second step in intersection to imaginary axis, we need to construct Routh array. Third, to find K for marginally stable system. So, in first column of Routh array, we'll be finding value of K for marginally stable system. And after getting K for marginally stable system, place K in auxiliary equation. Now, auxiliary equation, that is second order equation in Routh array. So, auxiliary equation, that is second order equation in Routh array, in which we are dealing with to place value of K for marginally stable system, and based on that we'll be calculating S, and that will be intersection to imaginary axis. Now, after using all those rules, we can plot root locus. And by only viewing rules, which is what we need to have it to have a calculation of root locus, it is not that easy to understand how to plot it. So for that, you should see some examples. So in next session, I'll be solving some examples which will explain to you how exactly we can have a plotting of root locus. So in next few sessions, there will be few examples which you should see to understand how to solve root locus examples. Thank you so much for watching this video.